Everything was just an accident, and my friends were just being protective, and it was really nothing all bullying. It was just that I was just, after overtime, being used to with how Matt is, and I was just basically was a scary cat. That was just it. Nothing really wrong, really. Nothing really wrong about Matt. He's not really a bad person.
I try not to be.
It's just how me and him are just opposites, and he's strongest. And over time, after me being a brat, and you're so ridiculous. But afterwards, I was being too much of a scaredy cat to say no about the interview, and I really actually, well, afterwards, I didn't even actually begged or asked Matt to take the video off. I just was just too much of a scaredy cat.
So if I asked you, hey, you okay with this recording? Instead of you saying yeah.
If you would ask that, I would be like, well, that depends. What are you recording specifically?
Yeah.
And then afterwards, I would have, if he would have actually, if he would have asked that or whatever, but I know it's not his fault. Really, in reality, it was never his fault. It was mine. I should have asked, but I forgot, and I was afraid of him, and because I was being a brat, and he was trying to straighten me up. But there is really technically no bullying.
No.
He was just trying to be a protective guy and just trying to care for people, and I was just being nothing but a judgmental person. And everyone's different. Honestly, everyone's really different. There really is no, everything's always good.
Right.
And everything's not always bad, so.
Lastly, I didn't threaten him to come on here. Basically, we've both been through the grinder and back.
You get the idea, what I went through.
I'll see you guys in the next video. And this is the supposed bullied victim right here, in my house, again. Months later after the incident.
But hopefully you guys can please remove that marker, strike, anything. Matt's really a great guy.
I'll see you guys in the next video.